Ladies and gentlemen, will you welcome, please, Andy Cameron.
Cities and through the countryside, from the towns along the river, the Tay, the Forth and Clyde, to sing for Bonnie Scotland, the best there's ever been. Ali, Tart and Army are bound for the Argentine. We'll be there, over there, in Argentina, over there. The best in Europe, we left them in a trance, and now we face the world, they haven't got a chance. We're off to Argentina, so far across the sea, where Scotland will be fighting for a World Cup victory.
We'll be there, over there, in Argentina, over there.
Win it, we'll steal it. So we will. It'll be magic, won't it? Look who we've got in the first round. We'll tan name Peru. They'll finish up. They'll start off with 10 men. So we will. Big for sight. I'll eat one of them going up the tunnel. So we will. Oh, well. It's very fun to a special Peru before a game. And what about that Iran? Who ever heard of them? Their centre half's a camel. So it is, and see, the centre, I think his mother must be Irish. See his name, must have a Duffy. Please yourself. Well, it's a game of football, isn't it? What do you do in the summer when there's no football? I'll do anything. I got the public partners watching the Knights of St. Columba playing the Freemasons. I says to the guy, what's the score? He says, I can't tell you, it's a secret. I was in one of the clubs, these Knights of St. Columba clubs. I walked in, the guy at the door said, sign the book. I said, Knights don't sign the book. He said, what Knights are you in? I said, the Knights of Noot. And this Pakistani come in, he says, how you doing? I said, oh, I see the Knights are getting darker. Is there any Pakis in? You need to watch them, you know. I can't see them with my glasses on. We've got them up here. This is the Yorkshire Park, by the way. You've noticed it. Lovely area, isn't it? This is a very posh area. Coming from Port Glasgow, you'll know nothing about that. But, well, see this place, Mrs. Berry Pan Loaf up here. So it is. See the bingo up here? They don't shout house, they shout bungalow. Okay. See if it's a single line, they shout semi-detached. So they go, oh, murder out here, isn't it? Well, we'll be there in the Argentina the same way. We're going to murder you. And it's easy. I'm a turn, you're the audience, all right? Well, we'll be there all the same. Of course, we'll meet you in it, because we're the only ones that are gone, aren't we? The Irish think they're gone, but they've gone to Alaska, you know? And the English, they're putting a last-minute bid in, they're going to write to Jimmy Savile, see if he can fix it. I don't think they will. No.
Why did I ever become a football referee? I want to go to the Argentina, I'm stuck in Pomadi. I shouldn't have been a punk or a comic on TV. Why did I ever become a football referee?
I started off my career handling lasses' games, and it was awfully awkward when I had to take their names. A centre half called Annie and a goalie they called Fritz, an outside left with bandy legs and a lovely pair of lips.
Oh, why did I ever become a football referee? I want to go to the Argentina, I'm stuck in Pomadi. I shouldn't have been a punk or a comic on TV. Why did I ever become a football referee?
I refereed a game for punks just the other day. I caught the goalie sniffing glue, so I suspended play. Then I heard a mighty roar resounding through the land. The centre half had bared his bum for the punters in the stand.
Oh, why did I ever become a football referee? I want to go to the Argentina, I'm stuck in Pomadi. I shouldn't have been a punk or a comic on TV. Why did I ever become a football referee?
I refereed a nerdy game between the blue and green. One side shouted bless the Pope, the other bless the Queen. Their points of view on football were as different as can be. The one thing they agreed upon was my pedigree.
Oh, why did I ever become a football referee? I want to go to the Argentina, I'm stuck in Pomadi. I shouldn't have been a punk or a comic on TV. Why did I ever become a football referee? Oh!
I was Ali and we won it. I wouldn't land at Albert Sinch coming home. I'd land at Heathrow and walk it up with M6. So I would. Oh, sickened them, right? Are you kidding? Have we got any English in? Yes. Welcome to Britain. Nice to have you. Okay. We'll tell you what the Argentine looks like when we come home, all right? And we didn't have Gina Welsh a doing, didn't we? Easy. We were doing it at Anfield, and it was great, wasn't it? Coming off the own train, your head's thumping, isn't it? And your mouth feels like a gorilla's oatster. And you're going up the platform with the carriage door on, you're shooting. Easy. I said to the driver, hey, what happened at Carlisle? I said, your train's up and doing and stopping and starting and backing for it. He said, it's all right, it was an Englishman. I said, was he on the line? He said, no, he was in a field, but I got him. We don't miss him, mate, do we, mate? We don't miss him, mate. Oh, I love the football. We take over at that Anfield day, didn't we? Right out onto the streets, easy. Into the first pub, doesn't matter if it's shut or no, get in there. Then we, right up to the bar, 2 pints of Drambuie shandy. She said, that'll be £32.50. I said, oh, for goodness sake. She said, take it or leave it. And I had my wee pal Clint with me. Clint, that's a funny name, isn't it? His real name's Willie, but we've called him Clint ever since he ran out of a Chinese restaurant without paying. Oh, we're in the pub, and all the banners are going, easy. And there's a lot of Welshmen in, and you know what like it is when you meet the opposing supporters? You like to exchange gifts, don't you? No, it's like a Rangers and Celtic game, you know? You exchange gifts after it. Here's a screw top, yeah, but you know? Here's a can. That's the game, isn't it? Is there any Rangers supporters in?
Yeah!
I'll keep moving about. You've got to watch them, whether that bitter a Ranger supporter, so they are. See that mob for Lark Hall? They'll no listen to Radio Clyde because of the initials. No. Oh, bitter. See, in the summer when there's no Fitba, they go and watch Catholic funerals. So do they. I was in a club in Lark Hall last week, and a wee guy, I was coming out the door, and a wee guy says, "What's the quickest way to the hospital?" I said, "Away in there and sing Danny Boy." I said, "Oh, the bitter up there." Is there any Celtic supporters in? Yeah! Oh, look at him. Beat Dundee and they're champions of the world again. Look at him. Hey, by the way, Joke Steen's gone to the Argentine in that submarine, you know. He's taking the team along with him. He heard there's 20,000 leagues under the sea. He's bound to win one of them, you know what I mean? With yourself.
We shall not be moved. We shall not be moved. Not by the Dutch, the Germans, or the whole darn world. We shall not be moved.
We're going to the Argentine, we shall not be moved. We're going to the Argentine, we shall not be moved. We'll be there to cheer the boys in Scotland's blue. We shall not be moved.
We shall not be moved. We shall not be moved. Not by the Dutch, the Germans, or the whole darn world. We shall not be moved.
We will be the greatest and won the World Cup. We will be the greatest and shake the whole lot up. When we play the game that Scotland's own, we shall not be moved.
We shall not be moved. We shall not be moved. Not by the Dutch, the Germans, or the whole darn world. We shall not be moved.
Is our captain's name?
Easy.
Football is our game. We will show the rest what we can do. Scotland will not be moved.
We shall not be moved. We shall not be moved. Not by the Dutch, the Germans, or the whole darn world. We shall not be moved. We shall not be moved. Not by the Dutch, the Germans, or the whole darn world. We shall not be moved.
We Celtic supporter goes to heaven, and the chaps at gate, St Peter opens it. He said, "Away you go, we're not making Guinness for one." He says, "I'm deed, I want in." St. Peter says, "You don't get in because you're deed." He says, "Have you ever done anything brave in your life?" "Brave," he says, "brave, you're asking me." He said, "The Rangers beat us 3-0 at Parkhead." That's an old joke, this. He says, "They beat us 3-0 at Parkhead, and they're all coming down London Road, all they Huns." And I'm right out in front of them. "Nine in a row, you about." St. Peter said, "That was brave. When did you do that?" He says, "2 minutes ago." But we're in the pub and all the banners are going easy, and the door busts open, and in they come, the IRA with the hoods on. I knew it was the IRA. The hoods were back to front. Is there any Irish in apart from Clem? Just keep your eyes on that, Clem. See, when he goes out, we're rocking it. Well, it takes a needle climb, you know. It takes a fence. It takes a gate, I know, if you don't let him away with it. He took a needle with me one night. He attacked me with a razor. I was lucky, I'd never to plug it in. I like a wee daft Irish ones, you know. A wee daft Irish ones. Paddy goes into the butchers and says, "Like a chop, please." The guy says, "Jig it." He said, "I'd like a chop, please." Two Irishmen kidnapped a wee boy and he sent him home with a ransom note. And his mother was Irish. She sent him back with the money. I'm laughing myself. I hear it every night, too, you know. Big Paddy goes into maternity. He says, "Nurse, nurse." She said, "Shut up, you're waiting the wains." He said, "Nurse, I want to see my baby." She said, "Who are you?" He said, "I'm Big Paddy." She said, "You've got the biggest baby we've ever had here. 22 pounds and 5 ounces. He says, "Look at me, I'm 6 foot 12. I'm nearly 7 feet. He said, "I've got arms like a tree trunk and legs like a billiard table." He said, "And see my thing, you could sweep a chimney with it." She said, "Just a swept it, the wains are darky."
Cry for us, Argentina. Just cry for an island balloon. And when we are finished, we're hauling. They'll sign Johan Cruyff on the blue. Singing Ali and Kenny and Danny. Big Tom and the York as well. With the rest of the team and their army. We'll follow them right into hell. With Big Gal and Ruff as our goalie, the boys will go all out to win. And if Alan shoots straight from his goal line, Big McQueen will stick one on his chin. So don't cry for us, Argentina. Just cry for Iran and Peru. And when we are finished with Holland, they'll sign Johan Cruyff on the blue. Singing Ali and Kenny and Danny, Big Tom and the York as well. With the rest of the team and their army, we'll follow them right into hell. King Ali, your army's behind you. From the border to old John O'Groats, and at Hagenfield Rock all the parkies are hiring out Argentine boats. So don't cry for us, Argentina. Just cry for Iran and Peru. And when we are finished with Holland, they'll sign Johan Cruyff on the blue. On the trophy, we're parting the wife and the wave, and we're all gone to classes at night school for lessons in hijacking planes. So don't cry for us, Argentina. Just cry for Iran and Peru. And when we are finished with Holland, they'll sign Johan Cruyff on the blue. Singing Ali and Kenny and Danny, Big Tom and Rioc as well. With the rest of the team and their army, we'll follow them right into hell. So don't cry for us, Argentina. Just cry for Iran and Peru. And when we are finished with Holland, they'll sign Johan Cruyff on the blue. Singing Ali and Kenny and Danny, Big Tom and Rioch as well. With an escort team and their army, we'll follow them right into hell. We'll follow them right into
and you've got a nice leg. It's a pity about the other one. But, well, they're going to that. They're going to it, aren't they? They're leaving the new. Some of them are away already. The cabin ferry's been missing for 3 weeks. So it is. And they're going in that submarine. That mob for circles. You wouldn't believe it, eh? Could you imagine it? It'll get to Port Glasgow. So it will. And all the wee bears will be stammering about like, hey, where's the driver? I want to stop for a pee now. So, well, they're magic, isn't it? See, doing it at Liverpool, them was great, in the pub and all the Welsh people. Of course, I like the Welsh, I'm related to them uncle. He's a shepherd in Wales. So he is, he keeps mounting sheep. Well, they'll get him. I come out of the car and he was chasing a sheep up the road. I said, he's shearing. He said, get one of your own. He sat his driving test and the guy says, could you make a U-turn? He says, I could make her eyes pop out. He said, So we're on the way to Anfield. Do you know what like Liverpool is? They're off at my daft. And we're going up the Anfield Road and there's a wee bar in front of me with all the tartan. And the Polish under the air, easy. I said, what are you doing? He says, I'm looking for a ticket for the cop. I said, aye, please yourself. The cop is the Polish under his arm. No, watch my lips, okay? I like your wee tash. Is that a tash your father wore? So we're in the ground and all the banners are gone. You know what like it is in that cop? And the two teams are coming out, big for size like that. I'm gonna kill you. That was Ace of Hartford who was talking to today. I like how he trips them up and Big McQueen heeders them away. Runs again. But we're on the terrace and all the banners are gone and I'm getting to the wee Welsh fella in front of me. Yaki da, yabba. Yaki da. And he turned around and he says, who are you shoving? I said, I don't know. What's your name? And this guy stood beside me with a bowler hat and a pinstripe suit. A Queen's Sports packer. I said, how you doing, Biggie? Want to be drinking the wine? He said, I don't want your wine. He said, I've got a big house in the country at Greenock. I said, oh, have you? He said, yes, I have. I said, do you want to be drinking the wine? He said, I don't want your wine. He said, well, I want something to drink. I'll go home to my cocktail cabinet. I said, I ain't bite my shirt. So half time came and I took the pie out of the pocket. Been in there since a Thursday night then. And a wee bit fell off it and ran away singing Follow, Follow. Because it was blue moulded, you know. I said, do you want a wee bit of the pie? He said, I don't want your pie. He said, well, I want something to eat. My two cooks will cook it. I said, I ain't brush my civet. So halfway through the second half, I'm bursting for a lavy. You know how you kind of get out. And I said to wee clunt, I said, what am I going to do? I can't get out. He said, well, I'll take it in his pocket next to you. I said, don't be silly, he'll notice. He said, you didn't. So I couldn't reach his pocket. I had to do it where I was stunning. And I'm going, wee! And the fella with the bowler hat jumped back. I said, oh, bragging about your big house in the country and your shoes are letting in, eh? Well, it's a game that fit, brother, isn't it? Magic. Do you think, how many do you think over there? There'll be thousands there, won't they? Over the sea, who's along with you? Excuse me. Sorry for working with your interruption. What's your name, love?
Anne.
That's a nice name. Is it short for anything? Annabelle or something? I hate when they shorten wife's names, you know. My wife's name's Virginia. Virgin for short, but no for long. I wonder if I could have one of your cigarettes. I've left mine in the machine. Thanks very much, okay. I don't use them, I take them home to the wife, you know. In fact, she's sitting over here, you've knocked it off. No, seriously, sure it's better than staying in the house. Some of the stuff you see in that telly. Do you ever watch the Waltons? They go to their bed at 8 o'clock. So do they. So do they. They don't get to sleep till 11:30. No wonder. Good night, Jim Bob. Good night, John Boy. Good night, Granny. Good night, Mammy. There's about 800 of them in the man bed. And the adverts, have you seen that advert for the soup? This is my nephew, Nigel. And this is my niece, Nancy. Have you ever tasted it? It's awful. So it is. Loan's desperate. So, what about him in the skis? Have you seen him? Him that jumps 30,000 feet with a box of chocolate. Who's he kidding? He's getting hard more than a box of chocolates, isn't he? As I said, there's no merit to it. Well, if we're a Mars bar or something. And her, it goes like that. And according to Mummy, I'm going to be a proper little one for the boot into her, so I would. That's not a wee lassie at all, it's a 52-year-old midget. That. She said, William's going to be a footballer. You ever seen William? He's like that as well, no? Going to play for Morton or something. No? Are you a Morton supporter? Does the big crowd no frighten you? Morton, the last time they won the cup, Robin Hood stole it off on the road home. They're on the telly this week, Survival. I went to see them and I got lost. So I did. I went to Capello. I said to a fella, how do I get to Capello? He said, just follow the crowds. I finished up Woolworths. That was the day they caught the wee boy climbing out of the wall at half time. We made him stay and watch the second half time. So we were in the stand. The stand is like a hen run, isn't it? All that comes out, it's foul, foul. And we're sitting there and the big centre half got the ball and he blittered it. Right out of the park. I said, well, by Christ. And the manager turned around and says, we're not buying anybody else. He said, know who I like in the telly? That policewoman. Do you ever watch her? When I look at her, I think I'm married a navvy. Look, you might see what I'm married to. I'm not kidding. 14 years yesterday. Can't remember breaking two mirrors. Look, well, that's just enough. We're arguing all night there. So we're arguing all night there. She said, I'm fed up playing second fiddle to you. I said, you're lucky to be in the bonehead. You always remember the first night you get married, don't you? We had a big society wedding, it was in the co hall. My wee fella come in steaming drunk. He says, well, that's you, Merrick. You gotta be a man and date tonight, you gotta be a moose and date tomorrow night. I said, that was a rat, I did it last night. Those are gem, isn't it? Actually, I love my wife. I worship the ground that's coming to. But that policewoman, she's something else, isn't she, Anne? Do you like her? She's a cracker. I only watch it to see if she'll make a mistake, you know. Know how she goes in to pull the gun out of the holster? Some nights she'll pull out around 38. Imagine she did that. She'd feel all right, didn't she, wouldn't she?
Scotland, that's the name. Football, football, that's a game. Our teams are no the same. Look out, Argentina. All the banners we can bring. Laugh and cheer and everything. You will hear us when we sing. Aye, aye, Argentina.
Scotland, Scotland, all the way. We'll support you on the day. You will beat them when you play the game in Argentina. We can make it, yes we can. Ali's got a magic plan. We'll no be an also ran out in Argentina.
Scotland, Scotland, that's the name. Football, football, that's a game. Our teams are no the same. Look out, Argentina. All the banners we can bring. Clap and cheer and everything. You will hear us when we sing. Aye, aye, Argentina.
We're flying out in big jet planes. Me, the wife and all the wind. She'll get a thump if she complains. Down in Argentina. While he's gone for down the stair. He's no wheel, we're saying a prayer. Try like hell to get him there. And back for Argentina.
Scotland, Scotland, that's the name. Football, football, that's the game. All the teams are no the same. Look out, Argentina. All the banners we can bring. Clap and cheer and everything. You will hear us when we sing. Aye, Argentina. Scotland, Scotland, that's the name. Football, football, that's the game. All the teams are no the same. Look out, Argentina. All the banners we can bring. Clap and cheer and everything. You will hear us when we sing. Aye, aye, Argentina. Scotland, Scotland, that's the name. Football, football, that's the game. All the teams are no the same. Look out, Argentina. All the banners we can bring. Clap and cheer and everything. You will hear us when we sing. Aye, aye, Argentina.
That's the last time I'm going to Liverpool. A lot of violence in the streets. I got mugged. So I did. Guy jumped out a shop doorway. He says, hands up your bum. I said, hands up your end bum. And see the police doing there, they torture you. So did they. They nailed my feet to the flare and played a Jimmy Shand record. You can imagine that, can you? Your feet nailed to the flare and Jimmy Shand going dee 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 dee. Your wee knees would be going like a clapper, wouldn't it? Did you ever watch that University Challenger here? You should see it in Ireland. It's terrific. So it is. It wasn't great. Belfast and Dublin. It was a draw nothing each. Bamber says, right, you're starter for 10. Geography. Where are the Andes? Murphy said, at the end of my armies. Look. He says, what do you know about Damascus? Mick says, it kills all known household germs. And he says, right, we'll try biblical questions. What religion were the Philistines? Murphy said they were Catholics. He said, you're wrong. He said, well, the Philistine next door to me is a Catholic. He says, right, there's 5 minutes to go. Nobody's answered a question correctly. Name three cowboys from the Wild West. Murphy said, Alias, Smith and Jones. No. He said, what's the nearest thing to silver? Mick said, the Lone Ranger's bum. The Lone Ranger, do you remember him? Do you remember going to the matinee on a Saturday morning? We come along, good Saturday, remember Lone? Throwing screw tops at the ice cream woman. And when you come out, everybody was a cowboy, weren't they? So remember that? You used to go down the street like that. I was always Roy Rogers. And the wee lassie next door was always Trigger.
Sarah, whatever will be, we're going to the Argentine, que sarah, sarah.
When we get to the Argentine, we'll beat the others, nae bother at all. Germany, Holland, Iran and Peru, they'll no get a kick at the ball.
Que sera, sera, whatever will be, we're going to the Argentine, que sera, sera.
And when the finals come around, our boys in blue will be in their prime. We'll be the greatest, cause we've got a plan to hammer them one at a time.
Que sera, sera, whatever will be, we're going to the Argentine, que sera, sera.
When we bring home the World Cup, 5 million voices will proudly sing.
Our centre half may be McQueen, but Ali must be the king. Que sera, sera, whatever will be, we're going to the Argentine, que sera, sera. Que sera, sera, whatever will be, we're going to the Argentine, que sera, sera.
I love kids. My wee lassie came into bed with me this morning. Know how they love their daddy, didn't they? She said, daddy, daddy, cuddle me the way you cuddle my mummy. So I gave her a big hug. She said, daddy, daddy, kiss me the way you kiss my mummy. So I gave her a big... She's 22 today. She said, daddy, daddy, whisper my ear the way you whisper my mummy's ear. So I went, psh. She said, no, I'm too tired. Well, you fellas are laughing, but it's happened to you, hasn't it? I know what happens. You go out a wee bevy and you come home with a Jacob off easy. Morton for a cup. Well, that's a laugh for a start, isn't it? And you sneak in the door, you take the shoes and stockings off and you tiptoe up the stairs, don't you? Look at all the heads going. And you sneak into the bedroom, you think you've got away with it. Your half road's done with the winners and losers, aren't you? And the light goes on and she sits up in bed with the rollers and, where the hell have you been in this time of night? You're doing it wrong, lads. Do what I do. Walk right in and throw the door open. Slam it shut and stamp up the stern like that. Throw the bedroom door open and throw the light on and say, I feel it a bit tonight. And she'll go... It works all the time. So it does. She says, aye, so it does. I used to do the same as yourself. I used to walk in, take the clothes off, leave them in the living room and streak up the stairs naked so that if she woke up, she'd think I was at a lavvy. No. One night I did it, I found out I was in a bus, so now I forget. Stand in the top deck of a bus, scuddy, absolutely naked. The wee conductor's nearly had a stroke. I just stopped on time. I said, get away from that. Like, kid, no way. You never know your luck. Okay. I'd like to sing this Alice Tartan Army. The reason I wrote the words in the first place is because I think we're going to win this cup. Do you not think so?
Yeah. We're on the march for Alice Army. We're going to the Argentine. And we'll really shake them up when we win the World Cup. Cause Scotland are the greatest football team. I've heard that said that Beckenbauer's the best I've ever been. Some people think that Pele is the greatest that they've seen. There's Bobby Moore and Charlton, they're England famous too. But Alice Tartan Army love the boys in Scotland blue. We're on the march with Alice Army. We're going to the Argentine. And we'll really shake them up when we win the World Cup. Cause Scotland are the greatest football team. Comes to managers, we surely got the champ. When Doherty and Dorman left to join some other camp, we had to get a man who could make us Scotland proud. He's our Muhammad Ali, he's Alistair McLeod. Hey! We're on the march with Ali's army. We're going to the Argentine. And we'll really shake them up when we win the World Cup. Cause Scotland are the greatest football team. When we reach the Argentine, we're really gonna show the world a brand of football that they could never know. We're representing Britain and we've got to do or die. For England can't idea it cause they didn't qualify. We're on the march with Ali's army. We're going to the Argentine. And we'll really shake them up when we win the World Cup. Cause Scotland are the greatest football team. We're on the march with Ali's army. We're going to the Argentine. And we'll really shake them up when we win the World Cup. Cause Scotland are the greatest football team. Yes, Scotland are the greatest football team.